Hello, I'm Randy Mason.
And I'm Nick Haynes, and welcome to The Local Show. Picture in your mind for a moment one of our area business leaders. Picture in your mind the head of one of our area corporations, and I am confident you are not picturing a woman.
Well, that'd be because Kansas City's companies are almost exclusively led by men, and not just at the top. A survey in 2008 finds that a full third of Kansas City's top 39 public companies did not claim a single woman among their top management teams or in their boardrooms.
In fact, more than half had no women on their boards at all, and 60% had no women in any executive positions within their companies. Our first guest on this week's local show is out to change all that. Ellen D'Amato is president of Central Exchange, the Kansas City Women's Leadership Organization, which has launched the Win-Win campaign that's determined to see women take one in five corporate boardroom slots and one in five executive level posts in Kansas City's publicly traded companies by 2015. What happened to all of these women, first of all?
What happened to them?
Yes. Where are they?
Where are they? Well, they're out there, and they're very eager, I think, to move into positions at the top.
This seems like a hugely ambitious goal.
Well, it shouldn't be. When you look at today's demographics, a full 50% of managers and professionals are women. The majority of today's talent pool is women. 60% of college graduates, females today. So it shouldn't be as ambitious as it sounds.
7% in your survey in 2008 of corporate boardrooms were filled with women, only 7%. Only 7% of executive-level managers and the management teams were women. That was 50% less than Fortune 500 companies all across the board, less than the average. So we're below the average nationally. What is happening in Kansas City that would have us so far behind?
Well, we are the Midwest, and things happen a little slower, but we're out to change that. We would like to put Kansas City on the map by vaulting ahead of even the nationwide Fortune 500 companies. Wouldn't that be fantastic?
It would be fantastic.
You know, and the fantastic thing is we want to do it because of the business case that shows so many studies that companies are more profitable, companies are more innovative when they have meaningful gender diversity in leadership positions.
Well, let's talk about the boardrooms themselves. I can see, yes, the fairness and the equity of putting more women in boardroom situations.
But I'm talking about the business case.
But let me talk about that. Why, though, why does it make a difference having more women in boardrooms? Why does that make a company more profitable?
Well, you know, Ernst & Young did a white paper. They relied on studies by a University of Michigan researcher, Scott Page, who's done a lot of studies on just pure diversity. And Scott's book would tell you if, for instance, you had a tough engineering problem and you got the five top people at MIT currently, and they all happened to be male and look alike. Then you got another team of five, and you put two or three women on it, and you got them from universities all over the United States, and they might not even be the best and the brightest. 9 times out of 10, that gender diverse team is going to come out with a better result than all the like similar people.
So how are you now convincing Kansas City companies of this?
Well,
is it the goal of Central Exchange to give this book to all of these corporate CEOs in Kansas City?
We start with a little bit of the statistics. Start with the business case. And those are studies that have looked at Fortune 500 companies and found that on average, those with more gender diversity have higher stock returns, higher return on equity, higher return on sales. So that's one part of it. But the other part is common sense. If half of the workforce is female, 60% of college graduates, 50% of managers and professionals, wouldn't you somewhat think 50% of the best and brightest leaders are women?
Well, I was reading a lot of articles about this for this interview, and one thread that came out of this was also, well, women tend not to be as good at men as men at tooting their own horns, blowing, you know, the trumpet.
That is something we're working on a lot. Study after study has shown that women tend to put their heads down and do their work and think they're going to be noticed, and surely everyone sees that they are good and will reward them. And that's simply not true. And even some of CEOs are telling us they'd like us to help them have their women make their desires known, make their goals known. If there's a job posting, women will look at it. And if they don't have absolutely every requirement nailed, they most likely won't even apply. But men, they'll have maybe 50%, 60% of them, and they'll go in and say, well, no, I don't quite them all, but I can do that. You know, so part of it is that desire to take risks, that self-confidence. Well, of course I can do that.
Okay. So you have 4 years now to get to 1 in 5 executive-level positions in publicly traded companies in Kansas City being held by women. 1 in 5 of those boardroom posts, those boardroom seats being held by women. And in 2008, we were at 7% for each of those.
Well,
so how do we get there?
Well, one
what are you
is
doing to get there?
Making the community aware of the business case. And I must say, I'm really pleased that the community has been receptive. Before we officially launched, we approached Bob Marcus at the Kansas City Area Development Council. We approached Pete Levy at the Chamber. We talked to Kauffman Foundation. We talked to the Block School. And they all said, you know, this is right. This is good. We need this for business in Kansas City. This is an economic accelerator. Hallmark, Don Hall Jr. was the first CEO to sign on. And we've talked about the business case. We've asked them to sign an accord, what we call an accord, that they publicly are identified with this campaign, that they'll have a work environment that's hospitable to women and helps advance women. And so we have a lot of support. And what we're doing, and we're accelerating it, is bringing in speakers from firms and companies that have been successful in adding women at the top to share best practices. What have they done that's working? So in April, we had Kathy Hannon from KPMG. 20% of KPMG's partners are female, and in the next 5 years, they want it to be 30%.
Can you name me one thing that they did that got them to that figure?
Well, they're changing their workplace culture. We still have this idea that people need to be at their desk, at their office from 8 to 5, and probably if you want to advance, add an hour on each end and show up on the weekend. Yet, the other thing that has happened in the last 50 years is technology. And as you and I both know, I don't need to be at the office to get a phone call from a colleague or to get an email from a colleague. And most of us are working, we hate to say how many hours. So we need to change workplace culture and get away from that FaceTime measurement and really measure productivity. And giving women and any employee the flexibility about when they're sitting in that desk is going to help women who, you know, nothing's going to change. Women are going to have the children. So at some point in their career, they're going to need some flexibility. So I think one thing that will help is changing workplace culture a little bit.
Now, you've talked about companies that have embraced you and said, oh, yes, of course, we'll sign this accord, like Hallmark Cards.
Hallmark and Sprint.
Have there been some companies that have said, Ellen D'Amato, Central Exchange, who do you think you are? We're fine as we are, thank you very much. Here's the door.
Well, some would like to see a little more information, and, you know, I'm not going to name names, but we have almost 70 that have signed on.
It sounds a little bit too easy just to say that, oh, we need to have more women, and now we're going to get to this target.
So
if we've been doing this for decade after decade after decade, and I've only got to 7% of women at this point in time, and all of a sudden we're now going to raise it to 20% of these positions in such a short period of time.
Well, you know, hopefully it's not too short. It's almost, what, four and a half years. And again, with demographics, I think it's not that difficult. And a lot of companies, their board is 8 people, and they might have one woman on it, and they add a second, and voila, 25%.
Ellen D'Amato, president of the Central Exchange, thanks for being with us on The Local Show.
Thank you.